Welcome to the Songwriter Connection Podcast, where we look at the craft of songwriting through the eyes of the songwriter. Each week, we make a connection with a music maker, listen to their songs, and hear their stories. From Nashville, Tennessee, here's your host, Dave Ledehem.
It's a pleasure to have you with us. Thank you so much for listening to our podcast. Songwriter Connection heard everywhere and all around the world, and even on YouTube. So if you're listening there, you please hit that like and subscribe, because that helps us, right? You know the routine. Certainly appreciate that. You know, a couple of weeks, this is what I love about this podcast is we have listeners all around the world, including South Africa. Through this podcast, made a very good and dear friend, and he joins us today. But first, let me tell you, before I introduce you to him, just a couple of weeks back, we had Exile on the show, and we talked about how huge they were in South Africa. They stepped off the plane, and there's all these people there to greet them and cheer, and they thought, were the Beatles on this plane? What's going on? They didn't realize how huge they were. And then a couple of weeks before Exile, we had Cindy Alter, who has become a dear friend. Cindy with the band Clout that came out of South Africa. And about the same year as I Want to Kiss You All Over from Exile was tearing up the airwaves. So was Clout with the song called Substitute. So it was good to have her. So we talked a little bit about South Africa and what it's like there today. And I first met Juan Casey because of the podcast, making a connection. You took the Mark Allen Barnett tour.
Correct.
And we've all been friends. Mark was going to make it tonight, but he had things. And we're taking this on the evening in October for a November release. But Sean, thank you for coming on our show.
Thank you so much, man. I really appreciate it.
First, I want to address the name, because when I first met you, it was at the Commodore Grill here in Nashville. And I come up and I go, Juan, how are you? How's it going, Juan? And you're like, I'll tell you, this is now you pronounce my name.
Dude, I get that so much, especially when I'm here in the States. People call me Juan because that is exactly
how you spell it, right?
How you spell it.
Yeah.
But it is actually Juan Casey. So that's my name. And look, it makes for a good conversation starter, though.
So, it does, doesn't it, really?
It does.
Yeah. So Juan is staying with us while he's here in Nashville, and it's good to have you. And tonight, thanks, we had this treat. Oh, you cooked for Patty and I a traditional South African dish.
Correct.
Tell us about it. It was delicious.
So I cooked babuti for you guys.
Babuti
with a bit of rice and raisins.
And you say Cindy would just go crazy.
I think she would like it. I think it'll take her back a bit. Like even when I just had a taste of it, I thought like, my mother back home, you know. So,
oh man.
And when I just as I left South Africa, my wife said, "Hey, just don't screw up the babuti, okay? Don't screw
up whatever babuti. Happens. You can mess up your songs.
I can mess up the songs. But don't screw up the babuti." So
it's like nothing I ever had. Rice and there's ground beef and raisins, and I don't know how to begin to explain this dish, but it's delicious.
Thanks, man. Yeah, it's I think it's originally, if I'm not mistaken, I think it's originally Dutch. It comes from Dutch, mm-hmm, you know, origin. But
okay,
the way I made it today for us, or tonight for us, is a bit of original South African style, you know. It's ground beef with a cumin.
Mm-hmm.
There's some black pepper in there. There's turmeric. There's curry powder. Raisins in there.
Raisins makes it. I just can't begin to tell you.
Man, I'm telling you, yeah. I love that dish.
Onions and carrots.
Carrots. And look, if you don't know what babuti is, go check it out. Okay,
check it out. You would absolutely love it. I swear. Now, in South Africa, you are a professional musician. You play all over, right?
Yep.
Share with us a little bit about what it's like.
Okay, cool. So in South Africa, it's a bit different than here in Nashville. So, mm-hmm, well, in a sense, I think South Africa is a lot like downtown Nashville, mm-hmm, downtown Broadway.
Okay.
People want to hear covers. They want, mm-hmm, to hear songs that they know, top 40 hits, and that's the kind of stuff you play. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And I play anything from, 60s up until, we even do Flowers, Miley Cyrus, play that. So we play anything and everything. If they want to hear something, and if there's a song that I can't do, people come up and they go like, "Hey, can you do this?" If I can't, that I'll most probably go back home and
learn it.
Yeah. And make sure that I'll know it next time. You never know, you know, who comes by.
Yeah.
But these days I try to, you know, throw in a few original songs here and there. I've got this good friend, Hootie. She's in Phoenix, Arizona.
Hootie.
Yeah, Hootie. Oh, I love my hoots. And she said, she actually gave me a very, very good tip though. She said, "John, whatever you do, finish every set that you play, because we play in sets, three 45-minute sets. So you have 45 minutes on and then about 15, 20 minutes off and then another 45 minutes and so on." She said, "With every set you finish with an original song. People need to walk out of there and they need to remember your song."
That is cool.
Incredible, hey?
Wow, yes.
So and she's a huge music lover, and that makes so much sense. So every time I do throw in some of my original songs in between, but I make sure that I reserve like the three or four best original songs to end off the evening. So normally I would end up the evening with a song like Piano Man or I Do Anything for Love by Meatloaf.
You have a great recorded version of that.
Thanks, man. I really appreciate it.
I encourage people to find that.
Thank you.
On Spotify,
right?
Yes,
Spotify, iTunes, wherever you get your music. So,
yeah.
And then I would finish off with that. And people would always go like, "Hey, yeah, one more. And then I would play an original song. And just so that people, once they hear that and I'm done, they walk out remembering my song.
Mm-hmm.
And I think...
it's a good idea.
Very good idea, mm-hmm. man.
Yeah.
I should give some tips to the guys here downtown. So
that's where it comes from.
So yeah, and that's how it works in South Africa, man. We wow. play everywhere. We play anywhere from bars, pubs, to wine farms, to shows.
You said you play a lot of the wine farms.
So I'm in Cape Town, South mm-hmm. Africa. Well, not necessarily Cape Town. I'm about 45 minutes from Cape Town in a little town called...
Cape Town-ish.
So... and there's a lot of wine farms in the area, and I play a lot of them. So, and anywhere from Wednesday up until Sunday,
mm-hmm.
anytime, afternoon, evening, you know, whatever comes my way.
That's cool.
Yeah.
And you've got a tremendous voice, and
thanks,
you've got
man.
Some great original music. So I'd like to get a song right away.
Let's do it.
Why don't you share one with us, okay? John Casey is our guest on the Songwriter Connection from South Africa, visiting Nashville
this week.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you so much. Okay, cool. I'm going to do a song. I spoke about my friend Hoots. Do a song. I obviously visited Arizona a while ago, and I just fell in love with that Arizona sunset.
Oh, yeah.
I got back home 2 weeks after I got back home. I sat down, and this song literally felt like it fell out of heaven. So hope you enjoy this song. It's called Arizona.
Awesome.
Down where the desert stretches white under the fiery sun, where the cowboys ride, there's a symphony of colors, a breathtaking sight. As the day winds down and the heat subsides, under the fiery glow of the fading light, there's a beauty that unfolds in a golden hue, where the sunset paints the sky with the truth. Oh, Arizona, what a sight to behold. Your colors blaze and the stories to be told. Arizona, your sunset calls. Well, I'm drawn back to the place where the wild horses roam. When every turn of that canyon feels like home, when you're lost in the beat of her ancient song, and the sun hides and the moon and the phoenix come out to play. As the air grows still around the fire, we send the day. Oh, Arizona, what a sight to behold. Your colors blaze and the stories to be told.
zone your sunset calls. Well, I'm drawn back to the place where the wild horses roam. To behold your colors blaze and the stories to be told. Arizona, your sunset calls. Well, I'm drawn back to the place where the wild horses roam. Well, I'm drawn back to the place where the wild horses roam.
Wow, Arizona with a wild horse's room, huh?
Thanks, man.
There's some beautiful, picturesque things in that song.
Thanks,
like a
man.
Symphony of colors. I like that line.
Thanks, man. I really appreciate it.
And having been to Arizona, watching as the sun sets, you can see how the mountains just change colors. And
absolutely.
It's just absolutely beautiful.
Thanks, man.
Yeah, good. And you painted that picture very well.
Thank you, brother. I appreciate it.
We had a friend that was here in Nashville for quite some time named Russ Lacoste. We lost him a couple of years ago, maybe not even quite that long ago. But he had a little place in, I want to say, Santa Claus, Arizona, off the beaten path. But the wild horses would come in, and he could feed them.
Man.
And they would come in, and he sent me pictures of him with one that he and feed him and stuff. You know,
that is just crazy.
I just can't imagine how that was.
No, that would be incredible.
Incredible. Wow. Well, it's good to have you here.
Thanks, man.
Yeah. Let's say hello to your wife and kids. You've got Melissa back home.
Yeah, I've got Melissa back home and my two boys, Luca and Hendrix. They're back home. It's probably, what time is it back in South Africa? Let's check.
What time? Probably early in the morning, huh?
It is about 3:30 in the morning back home. Well, seems like it. So,
well, it's a podcast. They can listen whenever.
whenever they want. I love my wife.
Guys.
Yeah,
I feel like I know you because I've seen your pictures and heard your dad brag about you so much. So
thanks, man. I appreciate it.
Yeah,
it's a pleasure being here. And I just love your podcast, man. I've been listening to it for some time.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
Yeah, I really feel that your podcast, The Songwriter Connection, truly made some connections for me.
Great.
I think
it's what it's all about.
It is what it's about.
Yeah.
I made a connection with Nancy Dickens.
I love
all the way from South Africa.
You're going to see her tomorrow night.
Oh, man.
Wednesday night, because she's playing at 12 Keys with us.
And you see, that's the kind of thing. Like, I've only had a chat with her over text message and never, met her. Obviously met Mark Allen through
Mark
your podcast.
Mark Allen Barnett,
Justin Love, me and him, we're friends now.
Justin's a great guy.
I met Greg Wilson.
Amazing writer.
There's so many guys that I just, connected while
all
I'm here.
All of these guys have been on the show, by the way.
That is exactly why. Because every time they've been, and I think people, they don't understand what the songwriter connection really, really can mean for you as a songwriter. It's not only about listening to some guys, chatting about songwriting and listening to a few songs. What this has truly meant for me is it meant that I can connect with what people say. Go follow them on social media, reach out to them, and have a proper relationship as a friend where I can send them songs or chat to them or ask questions or ask advice, because I'm not in Nashville, and having guys that I can connect with in Nashville makes it so much easier for me. Like, I can send Justin a message any day and say, hey man, I've got this line. Is this something you guys would say in the States? I'm from South Africa. I've only been here. Okay, last time I was here, probably here for about 6.5 weeks. But he would come back to me and go like, nah, no, maybe change this line. Or like the one song that I spoke to you about and you said, nah, don't use that line. Use something else. Mm-hmm. And that's the kind of input you want from fellow songwriters. And that is what this podcast can mean for you. And people don't realize that. Well, I don't think that. I didn't realize it.
You know, I'll have to pay you later for that, dude. That great endorsement.
Not at all,
fantastic,
my man.
Fantastic.
Not at all. And that is it. It is what it is.
That's why I call it Songwriter Connection. I want to connect folks from absolutely all over the world.
Absolutely.
And you from South Africa.
Oh, man.
It's just amazing. Yeah, you know? So it is so cool to have you here.
Thanks, man.
Talk a little bit about South Africa. The thing that it just sticks in my mind right away. You were telling me there's, what, 15 languages spoken in your country?
13 languages.
13 languages.
13 original languages or 13, I don't know, how do they call it? Well, it's 13 languages we need to speak in South Africa. Well, not need to speak, but that we speak in our country.
Uh-huh. 13.
I speak... and one of them is sign language as well. Official, that's what they call them. 13 official languages.
And now sign language is an official.
Sign language is an official language. Okay. So my brother's deaf, so that's why keep up with that as well. So I speak sign language, Afrikaans, English, which is our country. English is our country's first language. I speak a little bit of Sotho and sing in a little bit of Zulu as well. Do you guys want to hear how it sounds?
Yeah, I would love to hear
it. It's going to be a cover, but it'll just be...
Yeah, I'm very curious. So Afrikaans is the other major language?
It'll be English, and then it'll be Afrikaans, and then from there, it'll be, I think, either Zulu, Botswana, or Nkosa. Okay. So those are the three big... languages, other big languages that'll be spoken all over our country. So, you see, it's divided into regions. Where we stay in the Western Cape, there's a lot of Xhosa people, and Eastern Cape as well, a lot of Xhosa people. So that is the language they would, predominantly or was it mostly speak there. Mm-hmm. When it comes to KwaZulu-Natal, which is our East Coast, they would speak Zulu on that side.
Okay.
And if you go more north, anywhere from, I say, Gauteng, which is one of our provinces, mm-hmm. if you go north from there, from Gauteng and up, it'll be Tswana or Sepedi, I think.
Interesting.
So our country is divided into, not that they're divided at all, our country is very much in unity, but... Mm-hmm. There's in our different provinces, different people speak different, native people speak different.
And we're talking about a country that's about twice the size of Texas, as you were telling me.
Exactly.
So it would be like folks going to Texas and they had a totally different
language.
Language. I just can't imagine. And imagine as a songwriter, that's...
So as a songwriter
and a musician, you're going to go into a pub where they're... Maybe speaking five languages.
Exactly, 100% with that. So you would look at a crowd and say, okay, we've got a diverse crowd. I have to think about playing an Afrikaans song. I know you don't do a lot of covers on a podcast.
No, show us. Tell us what it sounds like.
I think we've got a bit of a different vibe here today. So I would play I would look at a few people in the room and say, okay, look, we've got this ethnicity here, and we've got, these people here and that people here. And I would think about, okay, what would they like? Okay, they would like more or less this song. She was more like a beauty queen from a movie scene. I said, I don't mind, what do you mean? I am the one who will dance on the floor in a room. She says, I am the one who will dance on the floor in a room. People always told me, be careful what you do. Don't go around breaking young girls' hearts. Oh, mother always told me, be careful who you love. Be careful what you do, cause the lie becomes the truth. Billie Jean is not my lover. She's just a girl who claims that I am the one. But the kid is not my son. Oh, she says I am the one. But the kid is not my son.
Wow.
And then I would do something like, Tommy used to work on the dock.
Old union's been on strike. He's down on his luck, it's tough. Oh, so tough. You gotta hold on to what you've got. He doesn't make a difference if we make it or not. We've got each other, and that's a lot for love. Oh, we'll give it a shot. Oh, we're halfway there. Oh, living on a prayer. Oh, take my hand. We'll make it, I swear. Oh, living on a prayer. We're living on a prayer. Billy Jean is not my.
Nice little mashup so that's, there.
So I would do that because
well that would be big here too. I mean you know
yeah because and the thing is you know people would love I would sing a bit of I would sing Lionel Richie and then the next song I would sing Neil Diamond and then the next song I would sing Elvis and the next one I would sing Miley Cyrus.
Now do you do those in different languages then or no?
No. So okay. we keep them in English because that's what people know. That's what they listen to on the radio. Okay. All of our music influence, I don't say all of our music influence, but a lot of our music influence comes from the West, from the States.
Okay.
So we do have some influence, obviously, just, you know, like anybody else would have from the UK or from anywhere else.
Right.
But most of our music influence comes from the States. So, and that's why when I sing, I don't necessarily sound as South African as I do when I speak. But different ethnicities, they like different artists. So you have to be able to pick out who and what and where. You know, you have to play some Afrikaans songs. Like I would do a song like I would go from when I was a little bitty baby, my mama used to wrap me in a cradle, right? In straight into country roads, take me home to the place where I belong.
Right.
Straight into on a warm summer's evening, on a train bound for nowhere, I met up with a gambler. We were both too tired to sleep. Straight back into country roads, back into cotton fields, and then right there, I would go into something like, oh, rij paard, ons rij die pad te samen. Oh, rij paard, so ek dier die levensbane. Wanneer jou rijdag oor is, gaan jou olijf lekker oor is. Jy van my. So that's wow. So the song is about a horse. It's about a horse that's your friend.
Uh-huh.
It's actually pretty much a country song. You know, it's about a horse being your friend, and one day, you know, when he's old and you're not able to ride him anymore, you know, you'll be there with him and you'll have enough for him to eat and he's done his job. But for now, right?
Yeah.
You have to take me to Tansani, you know. So you have to he's got to take you to his to your girlfriend. Okay. Like the vibe where of the galloping, right?
Yeah.
Of the part of the horse.
Group. Yeah.
Like there's enough feed for you and there's enough rest time. But now dra my oor die rivier se brug. Like carry me over the river's bridge, right? Dra my op jou lekker oorig. Like carry me on your back. Na my nooi sani die dochter van Tantani op die plaas. So na my nooi to my girlfriend Sunny, the daughter of Auntie Annie. on the farm. So and you would do that. You would go from
Afrikaans.
That's Afrikaans. You would go straight from like a top 40 country song, go straight into an Afrikaans song. Like a lot of guys do that.
Wow.
Just for people to, you know, keep the groove going and
yeah.
and
it's all about keeping that groove going. And I don't care where you're from.
Absolutely. Yeah. I mean, you have to keep the people going, and that's what you're paid for. You're paid for entertainment.
I've seen videos of you in clubs where they're all just on their feet singing Sweet Carolina or whatever. You get them going. You really do.
So I mean, that's what we paid for.
Like
I spoke to you earlier, we would do an Afrikaans song, uh-huh. and I would be singing the song, and like if the verse carries on, mm-hmm. the band or the track would keep on playing. I would jump off the stage. I would go dance with the people. We'd be on the tables. We would go crazy because people want that interaction.
Yeah.
If you don't have, and that's the thing also that I love about country music, even though it might not be that jumping off the stage and go dancing with people. It's about the connection, the emotional connection that the songs make with people. And that's what we as artists need to do. We need to connect emotionally with people.
100%.
If it's a vibe, or if it's you make them sad, or you make them cry, or you make them mad, or whatever it might be.
And you have to have that ability to read that crowd, right? What they're all about.
100%. And yeah. I mean, I play crowds from like... I would do on one day, I would do an 18th birthday, right?
Yeah.
And the next day, I would play for a bunch of old, I don't want to say old farts, but an old toppies, you know, like we would call them back home. Like old, I don't want to mention ages, but I mean anywhere in your golden years up, and people, they want to hear their songs. They don't want to hear this, you know, the songs that the 18-year-olds mm-hmm. wanted to hear. So
you got to throw them in. You know.
You throw them here and there, you throw them in. Like the 18-year-olds, they like the cotton fields, you know. They like the country roads. Those are classics. Mm-hmm. But, so you have to be able to read the crowd. A little bit of Zulu. This is Zulu. So the song is called Yankee.
Yankee?
Yankee. Not Yankee. Yan. Like Yan. J-A-N. Okay. Yankee. So it means
means something different down south here. In the States. Where you're from, what's it mean?
So where we're from, a guy's name would be Yan.
Yan.
Yan. Okay. Like my name is Jean, his name would be Yan.
Yan.
Okay. And then the moment you say Yankee or Yankee, it would mean like he's small, he's little, he's young. You know, like I would be Jean and they would call me Jean-Ki, you know, when I was a little boy, you know.
I got you.
Well, they would go like Davey. Yeah. The same thing. Okay.
Got you.
So this is about a guy who's away, Jan, he's away from his home, which is just by random now, the Cape, where I'm from.
Uh-huh.
And his mother is calling him to come back because his girlfriend, Katrenki, okay, is, her name is Katrein, but obviously she's still young. Katrenki is yearning for him. So this is what the song is about, okay? So I'm gonna sing the song in Afrikaans and then I'll do it in Zulu.
Okay.
Very good. Here we go. Yankee. Kom huis toe.
That's beautiful.
Katrinkie, sy wag op jou. Jankie, kom huis toe. Die kap is leeg sonder jou. My gang tang van die onderkap as die mami so op hul hakke loop. Wie kan dit hou, my dear? Wie kan dit hou? Neem my hand en vat my saam na die Dixieland vanand. Jankie van die onderkap. Okay, that was Afrikaans, right?
That's beautiful.
This is a Zulu. Yankee, Buyukaya, Ukatrina, Ukumele. Yankee, Buyukaya, Ikapa,
alino lutho maumeko abodzodzi kabie patsi nabafasi batande mali izuzupila ganjani na zizupila ganjan zatsi san la samisie spambaneni yainki wasikapa hepats uyainki wasikapa hepats
I didn't understand a word, but I'm telling you, I was so engrossed. It's just so beautiful.
Thank you so much,
in
my
both
man.
Languages.
Thank you, man. I really appreciate it. Yeah, so it's a beautiful story. If you guys go search for it on Google, if you really want the words and you really want the, you know, want Yankee. The meaning of it, Yankee. So it's spelled J-A-N-T-J-I-E.
Wow.
Yankee is the Yankee. Song's name.
I wouldn't have guessed a T in there. That's just me. Listen, we're going to take a break. Thanks for now that we know what it's like to be a full-time musician and how to entertain an audience in South Africa, we're going to talk about the original stuff that you're doing.
Here we go.
And why you're here in Nashville. Let's take a break and we'll be right on back. Don't go away.
You're listening to the Songwriter Connection, connecting with music makers and hearing their songs and stories. Now back to the show with your host, Dave Linehan.
We're back with John Casey, and he is from South Africa visiting Nashville, and just a great guy to get to know. And thank you for taking the time to do this, and thanks for that wonderful dinner tonight.
It's my pleasure, and thank you so much for being here. Thank you so much for hosting me. And
that's my pleasure. Absolutely. Hey, music, it's one thing. We could be divided in a lot of different ways, and we are here in the States, and I know you have been in the past in South Africa, but we both believe the same thing, that music is the great uniter.
Amen.
It is.
Amen to that. Can we have church now?
Yeah. Amen.
And that's so true. No, music is definitely the thing that's going to bring everybody together. And,
I agree.
You know, it always brings people together.
It always does. So let's talk a little bit about what you're doing these days and what the goal is for you. Now, even coming into Nashville, you have a tremendous voice and a tremendous style.
Thanks, man. I appreciate it.
Yeah, and just I can listen to you sing all night long.
We can do that. Once we're done with the podcast, we're going to sit there and sing some more songs.
And maybe we can even write one later on. But
yeah.
And we did not too long ago.
I'm going to sing that one. That's one I'm going to sing. Yeah, we did a Zoom.
God bless Zoom, you know?
Exactly.
Yeah. Right. A great gentleman in Australia, you in South Africa. It's amazing what we can do.
Absolutely. Yeah. It shows you that if you want to, you can make it happen.
Right? I think so. Yeah. Absolutely. So what is it that you want to make happen, John? Tell us about Sean Casey. What's the step?
So, like I spoke to you earlier before, the dream has always been to make music and travel. Mm-hmm. Like I said, if I can make music and I can travel the world, I'll be the happiest dude ever.
I know so many people that have done that. They see the world through their music. And that's living. That's success. We've talked about success on the show in the past, right?
Exactly. Yeah. And I think you have to put it out there. You have to go like, hey, this is what I want to reach. Mm-hmm. And it has to be it doesn't have to be so far-fetched that you aren't able to reach it, but it has to be a bit out of your reach. And
I think it has to be a little bit out of your
reach. It has to be a little bit out of your reach. If it's so easy for you to get, then there's not really a fight to it, you know?
That's such a good point.
So you have to crawl and you have to run, you have to make it, you have to climb, you have to try and get there. And I think traveling for me, coming to the States, is very much slightly out of my reach. And I've been doing it twice now, and I'm so, so blessed. Twice in 1 year, which is incredible.
And doing shows here. You were just in Richmond, Virginia playing this past weekend.
I just played, this last Saturday I played a show in Richmond, Virginia for, a bunch of guys. I think there was about 150, 180 odd people. Don't quote me on the number. And it was incredible. And I'm fortunate that there are some Afrikaans people there, and there's some, Americans there, and people from all over the world. Mm-hmm. And being able to play Afrikaans and English and play some original music is, that's a dream. Yeah. Getting on a plane, taking your guitar, and because our country with our currency, is basically at the moment it's about almost $20. $1 for 20 rands, right?
Okay.
So I paid 20 rands for $1. It's difficult to get on a plane and come stay here. And that's why I really appreciate you hosting me here as well. Yeah. So it makes it easier. But the dream has evolved a bit, though. Since I've been writing, and I always have been writing music, but never to the degree that I've done right now, you know. Mm-hmm. And since I've been writing music, I want to share my story. I want to share who I am and share who my wife is and my kids are and, you know, our life. I want to share that with people because that is universal.
I agree with you. I was just going to say that.
And sharing that story, having that emotional connection with people, I do want people to sing those songs back.
I think it's
to
all
me.
About that, making that emotional connection.
Absolutely. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And so that's the dream, and that's why I'm here. And I'm not here necessarily to, you know, pick up a label. If that happens, thank God for that. You know, thank you so much. But that's not the idea. The idea is to come into Nashville to make it 100% to make a connection with songwriters. That's always been my idea coming to Nashville. Making connection with songwriters, learning how to write better songs, and taking that back home to where I'm from.
Yeah.
That is my idea coming to Nashville.
That's it. So has your style changed now that you've...
Absolutely 100% changed. Yeah. You know, I used to write Afrikaans songs, not a lot. But my wife is the Afrikaans writer. She writes these incredible Afrikaans songs. Man,
really?
I'm telling you, it'll give you goosebumps.
Yeah. Does she play?
No, she doesn't play at all. But
she sings.
She's this lyricist, you know. You can take her lyrics, you can read it, and it'll be poetic.
Wow.
You know, I'll read you some of the stuff off the
podcast. Yeah, I want to hear it.
But,
yeah, absolutely.
And then I used to play a lot of rock music, so I wrote a lot in that style. But since coming to Nashville, and since obviously I love country music, coming here, I do think my style has changed a lot. I do think, and especially with Mark, you know,
Mark Allen Barnett tours.
He absolutely taught me so much in the time that I spent with him.
Oh, me too, over the years. He's taught me so much.
I mean, we met up with Danny Wells. You know, the first thing...
Danny, who's been on this show, great guy. Big songwriter, wrote Check Yes or No.
Exactly. Yeah, you know, sitting next to him, he goes like, I'm going to give you something that's going to help you for the rest of your life. And he's not arrogant about it.
He's not.
He wants to help.
Yeah. Right?
And I sit there and you just ask questions and like it just comes out of him.
Yeah.
I've got that whole thing on... I don't know if you know this or Mark, but I recorded that whole thing. Right?
Did you really?
I recorded it on my phone. I've got it here and I listen to it often.
So what was the advice he gave you?
So one of the things that he said, which I think really, really helped, and Mark said the same thing, is write, number one, what you know. The other thing that he said was, when you write, try and give, like you said, the imagery of the song. Don't just try and don't think people will understand or know what you're talking about. Show people what you are talking about.
Show me, don't tell me.
That was the thing that he said. Yeah, he said, show people what you're talking about.
Exactly.
And the third thing he said, rhyme. Mm-hmm. He said, if you can rhyme twice in a line or three times in a line, whatever, like, not even the verse, not even an A-B rhyme or an A-B-A-B rhyme kind of. He said, if you can write rhyme twice in a line, do that. Whatever you do, because it makes it memorable.
It does.
That is why we rhyme. We don't rhyme to sound like a poet. Not at all. We rhyme because it makes it memorable.
It does. And it's so interesting that you say that, because in a recent song, the one I've been playing out a lot that I absolutely love, called Barstool, in the bridge we go, check this out for lines, for rhymes. Huh? All I ask is a plaque on the back of this chair. You know?
Man, that is exactly
And when
what
we
it
get
is.
To that part on the bridge, you're like, they're with you, you know.
So, 100%.
Yeah.
And rhyme also brings rhythm into...
It does.
It brings rhythm into your lyrics, not necessarily even into what you play.
That's a great point.
It brings rhythm into your lyrics because there's phrasing. There's phrasing of this rhythm.
And that's what I think the thing about hip-hop music today and rap. I mean, that's what we've learned. I mean,
definitely.
It's its own rhythm. It's, you know, a well-written lyric like that is. It's just...
So I used to listen to some DMX way back when I was a teenager, right?
Yeah.
And that has always been like that. If the rhythm is there in the lines, you can. It's so much easier to pick it up. And I think that is something you've just given me a very good idea. Maybe we can throw this out to everybody out there writing songs as well. If you want to be a good lyricist, go listen or go read some rap as well.
Yeah, I think it's important.
Not necessarily go listen to it, but go read it. At least they're rhyming. I mean, they rhyme like nobody else does.
They can rhyme.
And that's what Danny said. He said, rhyme. So those are the three
It's great advice.
Yeah, absolutely. Man. Look, it wasn't my advice to give.
The best advice I ever got from Mark was, try not to suck.
Try not to suck.
That's a long joke. That's a joke we always say.
Don't bore us, get us through the chorus. That's what Mark told me.
Don't bore us. Let's get to one of those original Juan Casey songs, man.
Okay.
Tell us about the story of the song, and let's do one.
Okay, cool. We got to do a few more songs, right?
Sure, let's do. Okay. Yeah.
I don't want to keep you guys busy too long, though. Mm-hmm. But
no, I want to hear some original music here.
Okay, so
that's what this Songwriter Connection podcast.
Okay, yeah. So this song I wrote this with, and this is actually a really cool point to get into, a good segue for it. Mm-hmm. This is a friend of mine. His name is Andre. He goes by the name of River Wolfman in a town called Ceres back home, right?
Okay.
And he's a young guy, but he shoots from the hip when he writes, okay? He comes to me with these lyrics sometimes, and I go like, man, those are incredible lyrics. And sometimes I go like, yeah, I think that they can work on these ones, right? But he used to write so from the hip that I go like, okay, hey, man, I say write from the hip because I mean shoot from the hip, right?
Right.
That's the way he would write.
Okay.
And I would go like, hey, man, let's work these lyrics. And he came to me the other day. He said, dude, I've got this really cool song. I said, okay, let's co-write it. Because since I've been in Nashville,
I'm trying to co-write.
Co-write with everybody, right? I'm phoning up people back home like, hey, you want to co-write? A what?
Yeah.
So I've learned to co-write a lot, and we wrote the song, and he came up with these with the lyrics, part lyrics for the song, and hope you enjoy this song. The song is called "I'm Coming Home." It's easy. It's about a guy wanting to get to a girl. Done. Okay. Here we go.
Always a girl, right?
It's always a girl. I hear the engine purr. Feel the tires burn, leaving just a cloud of smoke. Long winding road, your memory. I wish I was in Tennessee, baby. I'm on my way, letting those horses run wild and free. Dream about your feet on the dashboard while chasing the sun. Like a four-speed, the boss was born to run. Round and around we go. Leave it all in a blazing fire, baby, I'm coming home. Food on the gas, come on son, rev it loud. I see the flag, we're ready to go. Sunset on that interstate, midnight stars spell your name. I feel desire burning through my soul, letting those horses run wild and free. Dream about your feet on the dashboard while chasing the sun. Shooting like a four-speed, the boss was born to run. Baby, round and around we go. Leave it all in a blazing fire, baby, I'm coming home. Oh, I'm coming home. I'm coming home. I'm coming home. Hold your feet on the dashboard while chasing the sun. Shooting like a four-speed, the boss is born to run. Baby, round and round we go.
it all in a blazing fire, baby, I'm coming home. Leave it all in a blazing fire, baby, I'm coming home.
I love it, John. I really do. You got Bruce in there.
Thanks, man.
A little boss man.
Little Bruce boss man. There. Yeah, there you go. And the interesting thing is, right, if the reason why we wrote that lyric was that specific line is because we're talking about, I feel the engine purr, I feel the tires burn, leaving just a cloud of smoke, right?
Right.
There's a car there somewhere, letting those horses run wild and free, right. Talking about a Ford Mustang.
Yeah.
Talking about a Ford Mustang Boss 302.
There you go. I love that
That's
car.
That's where the boss comes from.
There we go.
And then I went like, hey, if we write about the boss, the boss was born to run, because that thing was born to run.
That was born to run.
And so it's a reference for the car and Springsteen.
Mr. Springsteen.
Man.
That's so
cool.
Yeah,
so that was that line.
Very cool. Co-written?
Co-written with River Wolfman.
From?
Cirrus, from a little town called Cirrus in Cape Town.
In Cape Town.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah, man. Great song. I love that. That's want another one?
I do.
Okay, let's go for it.
Yeah, you got a captive audience. I'm going to hear another classic Sean Casey.
I wrote the song with a really cool songwriter from Nashville, Tennessee. His name is Mr. Dave Lenahan. Okay, cool. So this song is called 16 to Me.
All right.
Yeah, me and Dave, we wrote the song. I got the chorus. I phoned him up. I said, hey, man, listen to this chorus. And he said, well, that's country as hell. We're going to write that song.
Okay? We did.
So I really love the song, Dave. Everywhere I play,
people, I love what you did to it.
No,
I
really do. Yeah. People love the song. Okay. So it's got a bit of a, I don't know, a bit of Cougar Mellencamp intro vibe.
Like that.
And so hope you enjoy it. Here we go.
Oh, yeah. Remember that.
In your eyes I still see them glow, all those July nights not so long ago. You and I could never take it slow, wedding all those crazy nights go. I remember those summer nights underneath the stars, bonfire burning like both our hearts, the future driving us nowhere fast, dancing on the flatbed, holding your hand, I guess it's getting better. Oh, we were young, wild, and free. You will always, always be 16 to me.
Oh, yeah.
You looked as good as the day we met. That hot night I will never forget. We cooled ourselves in the Delaware River. The crazy how it all came together. I remember those summer nights underneath the stars. That bonfire burning like both our hearts. The future driving us nowhere fast. Dancing on the flatbed, holding your hand. How can this get any better? Oh, we were young, wild, and free. You will always, always be 16 to me. Some memories have a mind of their own, and baby, this one never gets old. I remember those summer nights underneath the stars. We had the bonfire burning like both our hearts. The future driving us nowhere fast. Dancing on the flatbed, holding your hand. How can this get any better? Oh, we were young, wild, and free. You will always, always be 16 to me. 16 to me.
I love it. I really do.
And I love that song.
It's got a great groove too.
Man, I think
you gotta record that, my friend.
I'm gonna do so.
Yeah.
This is part of the story. So when I go back home, it'll either be recording this on my own dime, which is going to take very, very long.
Well, I'll pitch in to help since I'm a co-writer. I don't mind doing that.
Or I think what I'm going to do is maybe do like a backer buddy kind of crowdfunding thing.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Because I think I've got lots of people asking me, "Hey, when is this coming out? You know, where can we find this?" And every time people ask me, you can just as might as well say, "Hey, man, if you really want to hear this, let me send you a link for my crowdfunding." I mean, you pledge. You don't necessarily give immediately. You pledge. And once the amount is there, only then they deduct the money.
Yeah.
So if it's fully, if your funds are fully all generated, from there on, then it gets paid out. And then I can record all these songs, man.
Do it.
And
you should do it. We need to have you.
I really want to do that. So. Yeah.
Now, you have some stuff out there right now.
I do.
Spotify and different things.
Yeah. So I've got some Afrikaans songs out there, which will most probably one or two other songs will fall away. Just purely because if you go listen to it, it might not necessarily be the vibe that I'm going for anymore. One or two of those songs will still stay. I've got a cover there from Meatloaf, "I Would Do Anything for Love," which I love doing.
We listened to that today through my speakers in my stereo, and it's just
thanks, man. I really appreciate it.
Yeah,
and then I've got some covers on YouTube as well. I do like "Purple Rain" that I often do. I do that song.
I could hear you doing that,
man. I've probably done that song a million times. Wow. So everywhere I go, people go like, "Hey, can you do Purple Rain?" So I do that as well. And then Tennessee Whiskey.
Oh, yeah.
Stapleton.
You do the Stapleton version?
Stapleton version. A little bit different. Because I don't necessarily want to do exactly what he does. I think it's important to also be true to yourself.
Yeah, and you too. Make it your own.
Yeah, make it your own, 100%.
Like you did with Billie Jean there. Which was really cool, man. I really
thanks, man. I appreciate it.
You know, the thing is, it's the groove, your groove, and you're a groove guy.
Thanks.
But also a great singer, Melly. But, you've learned, and I think probably through all the years in the pubs, in the clubs, in the places that you play, if you keep that groove going, you keep them active, right?
So I've got a little kick pedal that I normally play with, like an electronic one called an SPD one kick. It's got a little thumb to it.
Yeah.
Dude, like I kicked that thing. That was probably the best $1,000 that I've spent in my whole life. And because back home it costs $1,000. Right here it costs around about a few hundred bucks. But I would kick that thing. Shame, But it works and people love it. I've got a little looper pedal as well. That's why I would do like.
That's a real art to loop.
I would loop that vibe. And then while that is going, then on top of that, I would do the loop on top of that.
Good.
Keep and the then going. That keeps the groove going. You can literally play.
Yeah.
Man, I've probably done like 40, 45 minutes on one loop.
Wow.
Just carry it on song after song after
song.
It
keeps them going.
Keeps them going, man. That's keeps them cool. drinking.
Yeah.
That's why.
And that's what you have to do, you work.
That's why I'm there, man.
Yeah, you got to keep them drinking. Keep them drinking. What it's all. Keep that in mind when you're starting to play out with your songs. Don't do the one ballad after another, get a hold of me, you're going to love this one.
Exactly.
So, yeah, mix them up.
Exactly, you have to.
Some tempo.
You have to.
Yeah, you've learned that the hard way, haven't you?
I can't tell you, man. Like so many times. Awesome. But people do come up and they do ask for the ballads, people come up and they ask me if I can do Whitney Houston,
Yeah.
And then...
Do you do Whitney Houston?
I do Whitney Houston.
What?
And I'll always love you. And I play those songs, but I do them different. Mm-hmm. I make it my own. And I think that's important, right?
I do too. So. I really do. Yeah. How about another one? Let's take it, because I could talk to you all night and get sidetracked. And we're going to but one more song, we'll take it out. Sean, good to have you here.
Thank you so much, my man.
Thanks for the insights.
I really, really, really appreciate it.
And for spreading the word down in South Africa about us. That's awesome. Dude, man,
I'm telling everybody about this podcast.
I appreciate that.
Again, I try and bring this across to people back home, especially the songwriters. Say, hey, go listen to those, to everybody on the podcast, everybody that's been interviewed. It's not about the people. don't look at who's on the interview. Don't look who it is, what they've written, what they've done. Try and forget about that person, but listen to what they say. Mm-hmm. Like, listen to their heart. Listen to what comes out of them. Because without, like, even myself, you know, without you really realizing it, you're giving something of yourself to the people out there. And that is what I'm listening to when I'm listening to every podcast. Let me just tell you, man. So let me just say, like, the last podcast, or not the last one, I think it was, which one was it? I'm going to tell you now. Eddie
Heintzelman?
No. Eddie Levi. Is it, what's that? Eddie Levy.
Yes.
There we go. Sorry. Amazing. I apologize. I butchered your surname.
Great songwriter. More bluegrass.
That was one of the podcasts that I listened to and go like, hey, you know, I've really learned from her the way she approaches music. Not necessarily bluegrass, because I'm not a bluegrass singer, but the way she approaches, you know, her fans and people and music and where she is. That's just one of them. Obviously, man, Craig Monday.
He just played a house concert for us this past weekend. He just blew people away. His songs were amazing,
dude. That was the way he sings is just incredible, man.
The stories he weaves.
Oh, you know? It is just incredible.
Go back if you haven't heard that one. Go back and listen to a song called Crossroads that he did on this show. Oh,
that is
telling you goosebumps.
And there's so many. I mean, I can literally go down and.
Well, thank you for that.
Go listen to, don't necessarily go listen to the person and find out who it is. You do find out in the podcast who it is, but listen to what they say, to their words, listen to their heart. Try and you know, get something from that, because I think that's really, really, really special.
Thank you for that. I'll pay you later.
No, nonsense, man.
Take us out with that. John Casey from South Africa, I guess.
It's so difficult finding a song to take us out with. Why are we doing this? Why are we stopping? Okay, I know. Okay, cool. So I'm gonna finish off with a ballad. How's that sound?
Why not? Let's do it.
Okay. I haven't done any ballads.
Let's do a ballad.
So I'm going to do this ballad. I wrote the song. This is a solo write. And it's a really special song. It's close to me. I'm not going to share the story, why or how.
Too personal?
It is. It's personal. It's very personal. And it's not my story to tell, but it is personal. I'll share it with you later on.
Okay.
But
we can at least enjoy it here on the podcast.
Enjoy the song. If you think you're going through a tough time, sometimes you're not the only one. There's a lot of people going through nonsense, so hope you enjoy this one. Old wooden bar, grain under my fingers. Cloud of cigar smoke. A glass of cheap bourbon. It's these lies that make me choke. Do they know who I am? What I'm going through. It's a Sunday morning and a big old smile. How do you do? I haven't seen you in a while. I'm preaching the good news, but nothing comes good to me. Every night I'm awake wondering where it went wrong. I wanna drown it all, pour me something strong. At the break of day, it's only me and Jesus. When I look in the mirror, all I see is a sinner. But to you, I'm a preacher. Wooden pews, grain under my fingers. Sunlight's pouring in.
come to sing the answer. What should I say to them? They all know who I am. Do they know what I'm going through? It's a Sunday morning and a big old smile. How do you do? Haven't seen you in a while. I'm preaching the good news, but nothing feels good to me. Every night I'm awake wondering where it went wrong. I wanna drown it all, pour me something strong. At the break of day, it's only me and Jesus. But when I look in the mirror, all I see is a sinner. But to you, I'm a preacher. Oh, I'm a preacher. I'm a preacher.
Absolutely beautiful.
Thanks so much, man.
When I talk about voices in as a songwriter, not only a great singing voice, but the voice in your writing. Thanks, you know what I mean? Those are two separate things, you know. And I think you found your voice.
Thanks, brother.
Not only as a singer, but as a writer.
Thanks, brother. I appreciate it.
John Casey, our guest from South Africa. Thank you so much. And I look forward to hearing more from you.
Been my pleasure.
In the future. Thank you. Thank you for joining us, too, on the Songwriter Connection.
Thank you for listening to the Songwriter Connection podcast. Find us on social media at Songwriter Connection. Also, listen to Dave Lanahan's Nashville Connections radio show. It streams live every Friday morning on WOBL and WNOI. Look for us on Facebook and YouTube. See you next time on Songwriter Connection.